Okay, see here, today also we are going to see some more problems on the same, depend on the same concept, that is condition of congruency. We have seen SAS criteria. Okay, so see, today's first problem is, it is given that AE is equal to AD. Figure is given, it is given that AE is equal to AD, means this AE and AD are equal, this part is equal, this side is equal. Okay. Then second, what is given? BD is equal to CE. BD means this part. BD is equal to CE. Okay. And we have to show that triangle AEB, congruent triangle ADC. AEB means what? Triangle, this triangle. AEB and triangle ADC. Okay. We have to show both the triangles are congruent. Okay. We have seen, at least we need three things. Okay. With the help of three things, which are congruent from both the triangles, corresponding sides, corresponding angle. Okay, in that way we can show both the triangles are congruent. But we need three things which are congruent in both the triangles, both the given triangles. Okay, so here triangle AEB and triangle ADC is given. So we can say in triangle AEB and triangle ADC, triangle AEB and ADC. Okay, what is same here? See, AE is equals to AD. AE is equals to AD. First thing we have. Second thing, see, angle A is common for both the triangles. For triangle AEB, angle A is coming, and for triangle ADC, angle A is common for both the triangles. Means obviously it is same. Okay. And third thing, see, this is AC is equals to AB. AC is equals to AB. Why AC is equals to AB? We can see here AE and AD is equal and CE and DB are equal. If you compare both the sides there, AE is equals to AD and EC is equals to D. So we can say AC is equals to AB. Okay, that is the third side. So with the help of SAS criteria, side angle side, we can show that both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so now first I am taking this AC and AB. AC is equals to AE plus CE. AC is equals to AE plus CE. AE plus CE. This AB, AE is equals to AD. Is equals to AD plus, we can say DB. Okay, plus DB. Okay, so AE plus CE is what? Whole side, that is AC is equals to AB. Is equals to AD plus DB means what? AB. So this is our first thing. Okay. So from the given triangle AEB and ADC, one side we got AC is equals to AB. Okay. Now what we can say, CAD angle CAD is equals to CAD is equals to what? Which angle we will take? CAD is equals to EAB, angle EAB. Okay, why? What is the reason? This common angle. Okay, this is common angle for both the triangles. So this is our second thing. Now finally we can say AE is equals to AD. AE is equals to AD. Why? This is given. Okay, now see here side, angle and side. Okay, this is side, angle and side, okay, of both the triangles corresponding, both the triangles are equal, side, angle, side are equal. So we can say triangle AEB congruent triangle ADC by SAS congruency or by SAS condition. Okay, what did everybody? So these three things, side, angle and side. So we can say triangle AEB congruent triangle ADC, which they are asking us. Okay. Okay, see here our next problem is, if D is the midpoint of the hypotenuse AC of right triangle ABC, prove that BD is equal to half of AC. Okay, So here figure is given, and what they have told us carefully, if D is the midpoint of the hypotenuse AC, okay, hypotenuse AC means this is a right angle triangle. D is the midpoint, so definitely AD and DC are equal. Okay, and what we have to do, prove that BD is equal to half of AC. Here one more thing they have told us, of right angle triangle ABC, so B is 90 degree, angle B is, angle ABC is 90 degree. Okay, now with the help of these things which are given, we have to prove that BD is equal to half of BD is equal to half of AC. Okay, so this we have to prove. Now according to the given information, directly we cannot give proof. Okay, so here we need to do some construction. So before that, we will mention here what are the given things. Okay, so here given, first thing given, what is given? Triangle ABC. Triangle ABC is given. Triangle ABC, in that angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. In triangle ABC, angle ABC is 90 degree, that is given. And what is given? D is the midpoint. Okay, D is the midpoint of AC. So we can see here AC. So we can say AD is equal to BC. This is given. Okay. Now what we have to prove? What we have to prove? They have told us directly. BD is equal to half of AC. That we have to prove. So BD is equal to half of AC. This is our target. This we have to prove. According to this, we have to think about solution or proof. Okay. Now directly we cannot show AD or BD is equal to half of AC. We need to do some constructions. Okay. So here what we will do? We have to increase this BD. Okay, as soon as we have to produce BD, okay, we will take here point E. We have to produce in such a way BD is equal to DE. Point E we are going to take here, okay, like that. Here we have to produce, so I am taking that, so that we will show with the dotted lines. Okay, so here I am taking point E, point E we will take here, so point E is here, and now finally we will join this E to C, point C. Okay, E to point C. What we have done? We have to produce BD to point E. Okay, so that we need to mention in the construction. Okay, if we are going to do new construction, then that we have to mention. Okay, so produce BD to point E. Okay, BD to point E, such a way, what is the condition we have taken? BD is equals to ED. BD is equals to ED. Okay, this whatever length of BD, that much we have to produce till point E. Okay. So here we can say BD and ED are equal. BD, this and this is equal. Okay. So now after this you will get one more triangle here. This one triangle, this one triangle. Okay. So here BD is equal to ED construction we have written. Now finally our last step, that is proof. Okay. So in proof, okay, there are two triangles. See here, triangle ADB and triangle EDC or CDE. Okay, so first we will think about both the triangles. That triangles, the triangle ADB and triangle ADB and triangle CDE and triangle CDE. In triangle, in both we are going to think about these two triangles, or we are going to compare these two triangles. So we need to take here, okay. And now see here, if we are thinking about this triangle and this triangle, triangle ADB and triangle CDE, Okay, first we will see here what is given. AD is equals to CD. Why AD is equals to CD? Because that is given. D is the midpoint. So we can say AD is equal to CD. Okay. Second thing we can say here, ADB, angle ADB is equals to angle CDE. Why? Because vertically opposite angles. These two angles are vertically opposite angles, and vertically opposite angles are always equal. Okay. So that second thing we can say. And third thing we can write here, BD is equals to AD, because that like that only construction we have done. Okay, we have taken length of BD and ED same. So we can say BD is equals to ED. So we have three things, this side, angle and side, side, angle and side. Okay, so by SAS criteria we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so now we will write in the proper way. See here what is given. First thing, AD is equals to CD. AD is equals to CD. AD is equals to CD. Why? That is given thing. Okay. Second thing, angle ADB is equals to angle CDE. Angle ADB is equals to angle CDE. Okay. Vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angle. Okay. Now third thing, what we will do? BD is equals to AD. BD is equals to ED. Why? Because according to the construction, by construction we have done, this is first, second, and this is third. This is side, this is angle, and this is again side by SAS criteria. Okay, so here we can say triangle ADB congruent triangle CDE by SAS condition. By SAS condition. Okay. So here we have given the proof, this triangle and this triangle is congruent. Triangle ADB and triangle CDE are congruent by SAS criteria. Okay. So now if both the triangles are congruent, this triangle ADB and triangle CDE are congruent. We have given proof. If triangles are congruent, then we can say six elements, whatever remaining three elements. We have taken here three elements, two sides and one angle. Remaining two sides and one angle. Okay, whatever remaining elements of this triangle are completely congruent or completely equal to the corresponding elements of triangle CD. Okay, so we have seen. So now we can say with the help of this, we can say AB is equals to CE. AB is equals to CE. AB is equals to CE. Okay, this side, I am saying here, this side, three lines here, and here three lines. AB is equals to CE. Okay, one more thing we can say, ABD means this angle. I am talking about this angle. ABE, ABD or ABE we can say. Here we will say ABD, angle ABD, angle ABD is equals to, this angle is equals to this angle, okay, ABD is equals to CED, this angle, okay, CED, angle CED. Why, what is the reason behind this? CPC, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So that reason we can CPCD. Okay, so this angle ABD and CED are equal. Okay, because all the six elements of this triangle and all the six elements of this triangle are completely equal. Okay, because we have given here proof. We have given proof by SAS criteria. Both the triangles are congruent. So on the basis of that, we can see here AB is equal to CE and angle ABD is equal to CD by CPC. Here reasons are important. Okay, so now this is not our final answer. So now if both the triangles are congruent and here we have said this, so this we can say, and we are saying this is first, second, third, so I am saying this is fourth. Okay, so now we can see this angle and this angle is congruent, means ABD and CED are congruent. are equal. Okay, so can we say here AB is parallel to C? AB is parallel to C because if AB, and we are thinking about AB and C, these are the alternate interior angles. Angle ABD and angle CED are alternate interior angles. Okay, and when alternate interior angles are equal, that then lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. So we can see here AB is equals to CE. Okay, so directly I am taking that AB is parallel to CE. What is the reason behind this? Angle ABD, is equals to angle CED. Okay, and both angles are alternate interior angles. Interior angles of each other. Okay, when alternate interior angles are equal, that time lines are parallel. Okay, so what we can see here, BE is the transversal. So that also we can mention BE is the transversal. Okay, getting everybody? Once again, I am telling you here, BE is the transversal. So this and this angle ABD and angle CED are alternate interior angles. So both are equal. So definitely lines are parallel. So here we have taken AB is parallel to CE. Okay. So now we can see here in triangle ABC and triangle ECB. Okay. These two triangles, we know angle ABC is 90 degree. So that I am taking here angle ABC. Okay. Lines are parallel. This and this is parallel. Okay. So now angle ABC plus ECB. Angle ECB is equals to what is answer? 180 degree. Why? Understood. And from that 1 is given 90 degree. So definitely second angle will be 90 degree and sum will be 180 degree. Okay. So ABC is given, angle ABC is given 90 degree plus angle ECB is equal to 180. So angle ECB is equal to 180 minus 90. So that is 90 degree. Okay, ECB is equal to 90 degree. So this angle is also 90 degree. Okay, now this reason, what is the reason? Sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Okay, so what we can write, or lines are parallel, so we can say that sum of these two will be 180 degree. Okay, I have shown here. Okay, now ECB is equal to 180 minus 90 is equal to 90 degree. So this angle we got 90 degree. Now we will compare both the triangles, triangle ABC and triangle ECB. Okay, now we are saying in triangle ABC and triangle ECB. From that already we have shown that AB is equal to EC, angle B is equal to angle C because both angles are 90 degree, and BC is the common side or common base for both the triangles. So we can say directly now here AB is equal to EC. Okay, AB is equal to EC from fourth one we can write here. From fourth one we have taken, here we have shown. So here fourth one we can write AB is equal to EC. Second thing, angle ABC is equals to angle ECB. Okay, why? Both the angles are 90 degree. From which? So here where we have given to, that I am saying this is fifth one. So here we can write from fifth. Okay, and last one, BC is equals to BC. Okay, this is common side for both the triangles. Okay, so now with the help of these three things we can say triangle ABC congruent triangle ECB. Triangle ABC and triangle ECB are congruent. ABC and ECB are congruent. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent, triangle ABC and ECB are congruent, then remaining three elements, three parts, okay, other than this, are definitely equal. So I can see here AC is equals to EB, AC is equals to, or EC is equals to AB. Anyhow, we can say AC is equals to AB or AB is equals to EC. Okay, so that I am taking here now. Triangles are congruent, so we can say, so according to this, EC is equal to AB. So I am taking that here, EC is equals to AB. This EC, EB is equals to AC. EB is equals to AC. Okay, EB is equals to AC. What is the reason behind this? EB is equals to AC. What is the reason behind this? EB means this hypotenuse and this AC is hypotenuse of another triangle. Okay, so what is the reason behind this? We can say CPCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, because we have here, we have told that both the triangles are congruent. Here we have given proof. Okay, so EB is equals to AC. But what is EB? EB is equals to, what we can say, BD is equals to ED. BD is equals to ED. What we have to prove? BD means what? If you take half of both the sides, half of both the sides, suppose we will take half of EB, so is equals to half of AC, is equals to half of AC, taking half of both the sides, so half, it will be also same. So half of EB is equals to, what we can say, BD. Half of EB is equals to, we can say, BD is equal to half of AC, and that is our proof. That only they are asking to show. Okay, understood everybody? Okay, so see here carefully. Once again, we will have a glance. What was the question? If D is the midpoint of the hypotenuse AC of right triangle ABC, okay, only this was given and D was midpoint was given, then whatever given things are there, ABC, angle ABC is equal to 90 degree, D is the midpoint, so we can say AD is equal to DC. Okay, then this was the proof that is given directly in the question. Produce, now we have done construction, that is we have to produce BD till point E in such a way BD is equals to DE, then join EC. Okay, construction we have done, so we can do with the dotted lines. Okay, now first we have given here proof for the triangle ADB and triangle CDE. We have shown both this and this triangle are congruent. Okay, if triangles are congruent, remaining parts are also congruent. So AB is equals to CE. AB is equals to CE. Now, if AB and CE are equal by CPCD, then this angle ABD and angle CED are equal by CPCD. But these two angles are alternate interior angles also. When alternate interior angles are equal, that time definitely lines are parallel. Alternate interior angles are equal, that time lines are parallel. Okay, we have seen. See, if these two lines are there, like that condition. If this angle and this angle are equal, then lines are parallel. Okay, with the reference of this, we can say these two are equal, so lines are parallel. So here directly we have said AB is parallel to CE. AB is parallel to CE. Okay, now angle ABC plus angle ECB, angle ABC plus angle ECB is equals to 180 degree. Okay, angle ABC plus ECB is equal to, so see if these two are standing line, so definitely this is 90 degree, so this is also 90 degree. Understood? So angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. Okay, angles on the same side of transversal. This is now, if we, this will work as a transversal. So this plus this is equal to 180 degree. So now accordingly we have taken angle ABC 90 degree. So ECB is also 90 degree. Okay, so this we have given code 1. Now finally triangle ABC and triangle ECB, we have shown both the triangles are congruent because AB is equals to EC. This is we have taken from code. Angle ABC is equal to ECB, both angles are 90 degree from this. and BC is equal to BC, that is common base for both the triangles. So with the help of this we can say triangle ABC is congruent triangle ECB. If both the triangles are congruent, we can say hypotenuse of both the triangles are congruent. Understood? So here we have taken EB is equal to AC. Now we have taken half of both the sides. So half of EB is equal to half of AC. So here half of EB means what? BD. They are asking us is equal to half of AC. Okay?